In this video, we'll look at how to install Python 3.7 on Windows system. Let's get started. So first we'll download our Python. So for that, let me open my browser. And here my Chrome browser, we search for Python download. So once you search for Python download, in the first search result, you will see the official website of Python. So just click on it. So this is the homepage of python.org, where you can see the latest version of Python. So right now I can see Python 3.9.1, and we're gonna install Python 3.7. So just hover on this download, and you can see all release source code, Windows or Mac OS and other platform. So we're gonna install on Windows. So click on Windows. So once you click on that, in the next page you will see the all the version of Python. So I can see Python 3.8.7, 3.9.1 and 3.9.0, 3.8, and for 3.7 I can see 3.7.9, which is on August 17, 2020, and for this 3.7.9 I can see the different way of installing or downloading this Python. So we gonna download the exe file. So here we have this Windows 64 executable installer, so just click on it. So which will start the download for me, which will take a while, and we'll wait till the download is completed. So our download is completed. So let me minimize this and let's go to download folder. So here I can see Python 3.7.9. so for installation, just double click on it. And let me minimize this as well. So this is the first page for installation, where I can see the two options for installation. One is the install now, and second is customize installation. So for install now, by default it will install under the C user app data local program python 3.7 along with this IDEAL IDE, pipe and other documentation. And I'm gonna do is customize installation, and also same time let's check this add Python 3.7 to my path, so that way it will add this 3.7 to my Windows path. And let's click on customize installation. So here you will have this three option. For one is for documentation, second is the pip, and this IDEAL IDE, then Python test suite. So I just make it default and click on the next. And here we have some options. So here I select install for all the users, and here I have this path C program files Python 37. So I think that path seems good, and just click on install and say yes. So it is initializing my setup process. Now it is installing this development libraries and then executables. So our installation is completed, and it says setup was successful, and click on close. So now let's go to the Windows start menu, and here I can see this Python 3.7 module documents and IDEAL IDE and Python 3.7 manuals, and can see Python 3.7 cell. So now let's open this IDEAL IDE for Python 3.7. so just click on this one, which will open this Python IDEAL cell for me. Now first let's change the font. So for that, just go to options and click on this configure IDEAL, and here you have the size. So click on size and let's select 20, and Let's keep it bold and say apply and say okay, and let me maximize this. So this is your Python 3.7 Ideal IDE cell. So this is interactive mode. So what you have to do, you have to write your Python statement. So I say print and say welcome to Python, and for execution just enter. So here you can see the output of this print statement, which is welcome to Python. And if you want to create the script or the file, and if you want to put the code in the file, so in that case just click on this file and go to new file, which will open the new editor for you. And here you can write your code. So I say print and say welcome to Python. So this is my one statement, or you can call it program. And now let's save this. So go to file and say save, and let's say on desktop, and I say sample.py, which is the extension, and say save. So now my file is save under C, user, minus desktop, and sample.py. Now for execution, just go to run and say run module. So here you can see this the output of my script, that is sample.py, and the output is welcome to Python. So this is how you can create the Python script on this Ideal IDE. Now let's minimize this. Now let's go to the Python cell. So here let's expand this and click on this Python 3.7. So same way, let me maximize this. Let me go to properties and let me select this 24. Let me select this bar and say okay, and say okay. Now let's write this Python statement. So I say print and in brackets say hello world, and just enter. So same way you will see the output of this print statement, which is hello world. So yeah, it's works same way the Ideal IDE cell works. And even you can execute your program from this Windows command prompt as well. So let's go to command prompt. So here I have this command from. Let me maximize. Let me go to properties 24 and bold and say okay. So here first let's check this Python. So I say Python and say version. So here I can say this is a Python 3.7.9, which we just installed. So now let's check this the pip as well. So I say pip and say version. So here I have this pip 20.1.1, which is installed in Python 3.7. Now for execution, so you just say Python and say enter. So you will be in this interactive mode of this Python. The same way you just write your statement. So I say welcome to Python and enter. Now if you want to come out of this one, so you say quit, and you will come out of this interactive mode of Python. So even you can execute the Python script as well. So now let's go to this the desktop. So I say cd desktop And in desktop, I have this simple .py. So I say Python and simple .py. So I can say this welcome to Python. This is a script which we created in the cell ID. Yeah, so that's all for this Python installation process. Hope this video will help you to install this Python 3.7 on Windows system. And hope you enjoy the video. And thank you for watching this video. And see you in the next video.